Shalom, shalom, it's your brother Azariah from the Pittsburgh GMS camp. And today I just want to do a lesson about something I saw recently. Esau, well, first and foremost, all praise to the Most High Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shai, by Hashem Rukal Kadosh. Double honor to the apostles and elders, a great millstone. Much respect to you, brothers, out there preaching the truth and sincerity. Much love. And to the elect. All right, so, now, I heard one of the brothers in GMS Dallas, he mentioned that, and I think Elder Apostle Tahar was talking about it too, about this new movie Black Panther, and how it seems like he said that he has the feeling it's going to be Esau trying to push this, one of these final pushes for Esau, trying to make it seem like we're Africans, you know, try to bring a lot of people back to this whole African belief that our oppressors gave us a long time ago, and are continuing to push on us, and, I got two clips here just to solidify it, and I got a couple scriptures just to back it up that this is indeed what they are doing. I'm going to go ahead and hit play on this. I'll edit it later and put the little fair use thing on there. Salakia.
I have seen gods fly. I've seen men build weapons that I couldn't even imagine.
So I want to point this out. Now, of course, there's the confusion of faces. There are going to be some brothers here who are going to speak with a African twang, let me call it. You know what I'm saying? Oh, look at that. Inverted star. How convenient. Anyway, there are going to be brothers that are going to speak with an African twang, you know. Nigga, you know, for lack of better examples in my mind. Michael Blackson comes to mind, you know. Nigga, you know, this... I cannot believe you are, you know, not trying to make fun of nobody, but this is how the majority of the people in this video talk, you know, and this is indeed one of the examples that they're trying to push this. And then I have something to further solidify that this is a reoccurring theme going on in the media. So just bear with me, please, brothers.
I've seen aliens drop from the sky.
Yeah.
But I have never seen anything like this. How much more are you hiding?
Hola. Let's go, go, go.
We are home. Now, you got to notice something, brothers. Throughout the movie, they're going to kind of make this seem like Jake. You know, he's going to have swag. He's going to appeal to the black people, which it already is appealing to the black people, the quote-unquote black people, so-called black people. Anyway, just check out the swag they give him, but also check out the dialect that they use. I mean, look, she got the African head wrap. Now, of course, Hebrews wear head wraps as well, but she even looks African in the features.
My son, it is your time.
Show me my...
It is your time.
Respect and bow down.
You get to decide.
You get to decide. See, they all speak the same dialect.
What kind of king you are going to be?
You are going to be. But then you see they give him a swag of Jake. You know what I'm saying?
Don't freeze.
I never freeze.
Don't freeze. I never freeze. Everybody's speaking in this African dialect, except for, I think, one guy. One guy speaks, like, you know, normal English or whatever without the inflections or the accent, so to speak.
The revolution will not be televised.
Show me my respect. Bow down. We own ya. We own ya. We only getting started now. Cause we own ya. You gotta think they know me now. Cause we own ya. You and I'm my homie now. Cause we own ya.
I waited my entire life for this.
So, the world's gonna. This guy speaks, you know, normal.
I start over. I'ma burn it all.
What happens now? Determines what happens.
What happens now determines what happens. You know, you hear it.
To the rest of the world.
You will not be able to stay home, brother. You will not be able to plug in, turn on, and cop out.
What kind of
The revolution will not be televised.
Let's have some fun.
The revolution will be live.
Tell me something.
Now, this goes into the lore right here of Black Panther. I never really was big into it, but this goes into the lore of Black Panther. After this, I'll pause. There's no need watching the whole trailer.
What do you know about Wakanda?
It's a third world country.
Textiles, shepherds, cool outfits.
All the front. Explorers have searched for it. Called it El Dorado. They looked for it in South America. But it was in Africa the whole time.
I looked for it in South America, but it was in Africa the whole time.
The only one who's seen it.
And anyway. So, you know, obviously, they're pushing this Africa. The Negroes are Africans agenda in here. You know, I just looked up Wakanda for, you know, for research sakes. And according to the lore here, it's located right in the heart of Africa. You know, Ethiopia, Uganda, Nairobi. It would be here. Now, of course, I don't believe this is a real place because it's the lore of, you know. The lore of a comic here. All right, so before I get into the scriptures, I want to show one more video that can edify and solidify what I'm saying here. I think it might be in my document. Bear with me 1 second. Take a look. My downloads. Now, this one really got me when I was watching it. You know, I don't typically go like on Facebook or whatever, but I happened to this time and I was like, oh no, Esau didn't. Esau ain't playing. This is it right here. I'm gonna just hit play. All right, check this out. Once again, they try to use the swag and the appeal of Jake. You know, we got that flavor. But watch the agenda they push. Little boy getting it.
It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be all right.
We raise their children, then raise their buildings,
and they made billions.
I'm catching feelings.
Look at all the faces they got. Ooh, ain't that Lawrence Fishburne? Got what's this guy's name? These are people we all recognize. Really? And they're pushing Esau's agenda.
What else did we build?
Railroads,
Wall Street.
The White House and University.
UVA.
We built that.
Chapel Hill.
We built that.
Pyramid.
No, sorry, our Hebrew brothers get credit for that.
See? No, sorry, our Hebrew brothers get credit for that. So, they're acknowledging in a roundabout way that the Israelites are dark-skinned people. But what they're not acknowledging is that the same people who built this place, which is spiritually Sodom and Egypt, the Hebrews again today in captivity under the rule of Esau, Edom. They do not acknowledge that you are these people. The elites once again have used these celebrities to push that you ain't a Hebrew. Your Hebrew brothers did this. You just built America. You ain't built the pyramids. You wasn't the same people back then. You ain't God's people. You African. It's basically, that's how subtle Esau is, man. That's how subtle the serpent is, man. Esau. You know what I'm saying? go get a scripture real quick. And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord was crucified. This place is spiritually Sodom and Egypt, man. Matter of fact, I feel like I gotta go into two quick precepts. Because they constantly try to debunk who we are, man. They constantly trying to debunk that we the Israelites, man. They pushing these narratives, man. So like you, brothers, I'm just trying to make sure. All right. Anyway, so this is Deuteronomy 28. Basic precepts, basic scriptures, easy to be understood. And it shall come to pass that if thou hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God to observe to do all his commandments which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. We know this is talking about the Israelites. Go down to 15. But it shall come to pass if thou wilt not hearken or not listen unto the voice of the Lord thy God to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. One of those curses is what? And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. Well, what is Egypt? Because if you know history, the Israelites were not documented to go back into the Egypt again with ships. But when did this happen? Exodus 20 and 2. So what does Egypt mean? Exodus 20 and 2. I am the Lord thy God, which I brought thee out of the land of Egypt, comma, out of the house of bondage. So the land of Egypt is the house of bondage. And the Lord shall bring thee into the house of bondage again with ships. By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. So the people were here dwelling in a place that was close. Let's see. I have to find it. So here it's 15. So the people here were dwelling, make sure everybody knows, and they departed and dwelt in the habitation of Chimham, which is by Bethlehem, to go to enter into Egypt. So this is what they were doing. They were going to walk into Egypt. They were going to travel into Egypt. Egypt and Bethlehem are on the same continent. They didn't need a ship to go there. All right. So they were looking to go in. Most High said, don't. Most High said, be not afraid of the king of Babylon, of whom ye are afraid. Be not afraid of him, saith the Lord, for I am with you to save you and to deliver you from his hand. And I will shew mercies unto you, that he may have mercy upon you, and cause you to return to your land. But if ye say, we will not dwell in this land, so he told them to stay put, don't be afraid. But if they said not, no, we will go into the land of Egypt, where we shall see no war, because this is they thought they was going to escape the curses, man. Nor hear the sound of the trumpet, nor have hunger of bread, and there will we dwell. And now therefore hear the word of the Lord, ye remnant of Judah, thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel. If ye wholly set your faces to enter into Egypt, and go to sojourn there, then it shall come to pass that the sword which ye fear shall overtake you there. in the land of Egypt, in the famine whereof you were afraid, shall follow close after you there in Egypt, and there ye shall die. So shall it be with all the men that set their faces to go into Egypt to sojourn there. They shall die by the sword, by the famine, and by the pestilence, and none of them shall remain or escape from the evil that I will bring upon them. See, all right, now look, by the way whereof you spake unto thee, says, so shall my fear be poured forth upon you, and ye shall enter into Egypt, and ye shall be in execration and astonishment and a curse and in a reproach, and ye shall see this place no more. So they were in Chimham, which is close to Bethlehem, and he told them, you shall see this place no more if you disobey me this day, right? If you do not hearken, come on, reopen. If you do not hearken unto the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. And not only this day, but period, man. If you do not do what the Most High tells you, this is what can come to pass. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again, the house of bondage again, with ships, by the way whereof I spake unto thee. Ye shall see it no more again. And ye shall see this place no more. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you, meaning no man shall save you or redeem you from your situation. Because you know the Hebrew Israelites, you know the blacks and Latinos, Native Americans, primarily the ones that are documented in this land are the Judites, the blacks, the Negroes. You know we were sold to our enemies, man. And nobody saved us from that situation. And nobody still haven't saved us. None of our leaders have been able to save us from the persecution of this damn devil. All right. So, yeah, man. You ain't finna keep pushing this narrative that we not the Hebrews, man.
Let's get credit for that. No, sorry, y'all. Hebrew brothers get credit for that.
We are the Hebrews, man. What you mean? See? So I'm guessing Africans came up with that. So I'm guessing Africans came up with the hit them folks. I guess Africans sing like this.
Down, we still ain't got nothing.
We built this.
They have the nerve to
we built this.
Put them in the pews like they in the choir. You don't see no. I mean, I'm sure they got African churches, man, but they not known for being the best singers, man. Negroes are.
Tomorrow when I hit the field, I'ma keep running.
We did everything that the overseer wanted.
And if we got paid, then we'd be stunned.
Sugar cane, cotton hay.
My blood is sweat, paid for this land.
Now look, yeah. Matter of fact, I want to talk about my
I mean this.
My life would be different if I didn't have cinnamon pigment. My life would have been different if I didn't have cinnamon pigment. You know, it's just the subtleties of this, man. The subtleties of this, man. Now, when you think about it, ruddy. You look at a cinnamon stick, man. Let's look at a cinnamon stick. You know, got like a little copperish little, almost like a brass tone to it, you know? Brownish, brash type of tone. And primarily when you think African, they don't typically have the skin. But it ain't all about skin color, man. Ain't all about skin color. But it's just, I just find it interesting that they said that. So anyway, man. Let's close this. Get some scriptures real quick so I can go ahead and close this out. So this is Psalms 83, we're starting at verse 3. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. For they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee. You know, and it's funny when they say the word confederate, because, you know, there was a Confederate army back during the Civil War times, and they were fighting over slavery. Some people wanted to keep it, some people didn't. Now, I'm going to go into Judah. Now, this is one of the reasons why Esau is pushing so hard to keep us asleep, man. So this is Judah, chapter 5, verse 17. And whilst they sin not before their God, they prosper, because the God that hateth iniquity was with them. But when they departed from the way which he appointed them, they were destroyed in many battles, very sore, and were led captives into a land that was not theirs. And the temple of their God was cast to the ground, and their cities were taken by the enemies. But now are they returned to their God, and are come up from the places which they were scattered, and have possessed Jerusalem, where their sanctuary is, and are seated in the hill country, for it was desolate. Now therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error against this people, and they sin against their God, let us consider that this shall be their ruin, and let us go up, and we shall overcome them. But if there be no iniquity in their nation, let my Lord now pass by, lest their Lord defend them, and their God before them, and we become a reproach before all the world. So that's what it is, man. These people got to keep you in sin. They got to keep sneaking pork in your food. They got to, you know, make you feel like you can eat shrimp like G-Man. You can eat pork. You can eat all these abominable things. Because why? Now, therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be any error against this people, and they sin against their God, let us consider that this shall be their ruin, and let us go up, and we shall overcome them. They knew, man. They knew that when we were with our power, the Most High, they couldn't touch us, man. Whilst they sinned not before their God, they prospered, because the God that hateth iniquity was with them. As long as they keep us as a nation in the midst of sin, that's it. You know, and of course it's prophesied to happen that way, man. But Esau kicking in, man. Devil has come to you. Wait, no, let me see here. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a short time. He knows he got a short time, man, and he's coming with all the tactics he can to try to one last push. You African, that's what they're trying to push, man. That is what they're trying to push. You know what? And you're not an African, man. You Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, and you confusion the face Akiam, whose spirit resonates with the scriptures, the true word of the scriptures. He that believeth on me, of the scriptures saith, from his belly shall flow rivers of living water. You confusion of faith, Akiam, that resonate with the scriptures in sincerity and truth. And you Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans who can trace your lineage and, you know, go back to your fathers being a Black, Latino, and Native American descent. You are the children of Israel, man. The true children of God. You're not African. Israel is on the continent of Africa. White man has divided to say, oh, it's a different location. No, it's still connected to the continent. But Israel is the focal point, man. Not these different tribes, not these different nations there. You know, none of them, ain't none of them trying to reach out and come over here and say, you are brothers and sisters. They don't care about you, man. But over and over, our people are being paid to portray this image to us, man, that we Africans, that our heritage goes back to some African continent, that like it's something to be proud of. No, man, I mean, we ain't supposed to be proud that we Israelites, but you know what? It's a good thing. It's a rejoicing situation to know that you are Israelite, especially if you know this truth, man. It is something to be happy about, but pride is not pride. Most I don't like pride, man. Anyway, man, hopefully y'all brothers was edified. There's something I wanted to go into. Sorry, I hit the mic. I didn't mean to. But call halal Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahwashai Ba'ashim Rakal Kadash. Double honor to the apostles and elders, a great millstone. Much love to you, brothers out there preaching the truth and sincerity. Shalom.